What up? So as you can see by the title, I am showing you how to make GFX, Roblox GFX. So I'm just showing you how I do it. So you might get mad and be like, I don't know it's an easy way, but this is just the way I do it. So this is for all the beginners, they just want to use my way, right? You can use any way you want to, but I'm just showing you my way. You know, I just want to help people out. Okay, but, so first go to Roblox Studio. Then have an empty, place right here. And go push, when you go up, go here. Go up, push, play. Well, yeah, go to test, then go push play. Okay, right there. And then it should load up. Oh, my studio not responding. Okay, there we go. So mine's taking a little bit, but it should be loading up in a tiny little bit. There we go. So this is my character. You can walk around a little bit. 1, 2. But then line up your character like this. There. And then go here. Push pause. Go workspace, then go to your model. Go to this. It should say your robot's name. I don't know. Probably not. But it should. I'm not sure. I just go to it and then highlight all the parts of it. All the parts of your player like that. Push control C to copy, then push stop, then push control V to paste it after you stop, then push control G to make it a model. There, model. Then move around and see, it will say model on top of your head, or probably say workspace. I don't know what it'll say. Right click. Then right click, then go to export selection right here. Export selection. Then I'm gonna say save yours anywhere you want to. I'm gonna save mine in pictures and then name it The Boy with GFX. I don't know, I just named it anything. Okay, there. So after that, it should save. Then close this out, or let's make it small if you want to, but I'm just gonna make it small. Kick the go back. So then after that, download this program called Blender. Let me restart it up so I can show y'all something. So install this program called Blender. You see right here, you can download it on the internet and on Google or anything, or Microsoft Edge or Internet Explorer. Then just open it up. It's free, by the way. It's free. It's like a 3D model thing. I don't know what it is, but I just use it for GFX because it's a pretty good program. Or you can use Cinema 3D, but I really don't know how to use that. I use this. When you see this square, when you open it up, you should see a square. But just push X. Don't push control, just push X and push delete. Then after that, to go to file, import, and wavefront.obj. This go to wherever you saved it at. I saved mine in pictures. So I'll go back. pictures. And here you go. Mine was the bubble GFS. Make sure to open the .obj file, not the .mtl. Make sure it's the .obj. Double click it. Then there you go. Then push hold shift and F. Hold shift F. Then use WASD to move around. So hold shift F and move. Use WASD to move around. Then like that. Then push left click to get out of that out of this moving mode. And you can see your character is white. So go to this little white bubble down here. Push it. Click it. Push material. There. It should be like that. Just make sure my recording still going. So make sure you click it. Then after you have clicked it, it's gonna be like this, but I know what to do, I know how to fix that. You have to go to, you see over here, so go over here, push this earth right here, this world right here, let's click it once, then go down and you should see environment lighting. You should click on world, then go to environment lighting and check environment lighting. See, and then check indirect lighting. And there, you should have colors. You want to check ambient occlusion. Just uncheck environment lighting and indirect lighting. Let's see. Oh yeah, come back. Okay, so then go back to that camera, push the camera icon again, and after that you can, like, if you want to make your person do a pose or something, like say if you want him to wave or something, or just make him stand a different, then left click on any of the things, like left click. And here, just left click on the arm, and then right click on it. Then go down, go to edit mode. Then your whole arm should be edited. Your whole arm should be lighted up. And then to rotate it, hold Control R. You just hold R, you just push R to control it. Then it should go up and down and stuff. Yeah. So after that, you go back to object mode once you're done, making it go up. So yeah, I just wanted to add a little color to my arm, so it's a little more realistic. Like he have like a. Like it's suit kind of baggy right there. So I'm just showing you what y'all can do with this. You can see. You can make your turn, push Control R, but you have to go in edit mode. Remember that. Then click on the arm and stuff. Okay. After that, go to. After that, go to any name you want to. After that, go to the world. Stay on the camera. Stay on the camera. And no, no.